Hello, I'm Florent Boston, a concept and background artist in the video game and animation industries. Welcome to the third video of this series, Create a Narrative Environment Painting. This time, you will see the recorded process from beginning to end, which will be divided into three parts. I use the 3D blocking technique that we saw in the first video. This video will be dedicated to the mood board, design and composition research. Let's start. Basically, the idea came to me from a dream where I was in a city with a huge tower and a big bridge. I tried to transcribe the feeling of wonder that I'd felt. It was hard to reproduce on a flat image, but I tried to find the right balance between what I had in mind and what was possible to represent. As usual, I made my mood board in pure ref with different categories. I was inspired by the station of La Rochelle, Big Ben, and the Quai d'Orsay for the design. I like the volumes and colors of these buildings. I also took some Parisian buildings as a reference. I also wanted my image to connect to time, so I looked for references to clocks and beds. For the atmosphere, I went for a fiery sunset. At first, I hesitated to have blue shadows, but to respect what I had in my dream, I moved away from this track. Then, I started researching composition, the main building being the clock tower. I tried different focal lengths, some with a tower that fills all the composition to show its size, others a little more zoomed out to see the city. I usually have a process when I do composition research, but this time I let myself go. Sometimes I make several layers, sometimes I paint everything on one. I create them on a dark gray background, almost black, because when it's too light, it can distort the values. In terms of light, I experimented with a backlight sun, frontal and artificial light that will come from below. Generally, I stayed on value shame from darkest to lightest. Often, I start with the background and I add the elements progressively until the foreground. Of course, it depends on the composition. I avoid zooming in to always have an overview of the composition. Sometimes, I use a lasso to create silhouettes quickly, and I use a clipping layer to add texture. Then I add light and different volumes. I use a multiply layers for the shadows and a level layer with a mask for the light. I play with a mask to show or hide the light. To have a glow effect, I use a linear dodge layer. For the design, I wanted to give an excessive aspect to the tower. I wanted there to be a connection with time, hence the presence of clocks and later bells. We can see that the more I advance in the research, the more the tower grows and becomes more complex. Unlike the previous video, here I am in a rather semi-realistic style, so I do not distort things to deal with it. I create it in the variation of size of the elements and details. As it is a personal project, you will see that I gave myself the freedom to change the design so that the good elements are highlighted in my final composition. Once I have a recherche that I like, I enlarge it, reduce the opacity, and move on to the line. The idea is to follow the silhouette, but I still allow myself adjustments. There, I look carefully at the references and add information of texture and design. I did my research and the design from the front to not think about perspective. Thanks to it, I can make quick iteration and concentrate on other things. I did not hesitate to deform and duplicate the elements. Even during the design stage, I keep playing with different parameters, which are the spacing between the elements, their size, and their distribution. That's it for the first part. See you in the second part, which will be a bit technical for the creation of the 3D base. Thanks for watching.